We welcome you to enjoy this Blackstone audiobook from Abdo Zoom. This one-of-a-kind collection consists of 6 read-to-me titles, books that kids love in the classroom. Get ready for an amazing listening experience that connects the school library to your home and keeps the learning going.
Musical Notes, Country Music History by Kenny Abdo. Country music. Whether crooned by a cowboy or performed to a sold-out stadium, country music has always been relatable to its fans. Country music has roots deep in American culture. It is a mix of folk music and cowboy songs from the days on the frontier. Opening act. Eck Robertson recorded the first commercial country record in 1922. His song, Arkansas Traveler, was recorded with fellow fiddler Henry C. Gilliland. Jimmy Rogers recorded Blue Yodel in 1927, and people really liked it. It is credited as the first single to sell a million copies. Headliner. Ernest Tubb created honky-tonk country music. His single, Walking the Floor Over You, became an overnight hit in 1941. Tubb made country a nationwide sound after that. Webb Pierce used the pedal steel guitar for his 1956 hit, Slowly. The instrument became a defining sound in country music. In the 70s, some musicians felt country music had gotten too polished. Singers like Willie Nelson, Johnny Cash, and Waylon Jennings went back to the genre's roots. They led the outlaw country movement. Garth Brooks, Alan Jackson, and Reba McEntire all scored big hits in the 80s. They were able to infuse country with an energy that bridged 20th and 21st century country music. Carrie Underwood is a powerhouse in the country scene. She tours around the world, and her albums have sold more than 60 million copies. In 2019, Underwood broke the record for most CMT wins with 20 incredible awards, proving country music is here to stay. Musical Notes, Jazz Music History by Kenny Abdo. Jazz music. Jamming throughout the years, jazz music has made its mark as one of the most important genres in music history. Improvisation is an important part of jazz. The music usually includes a piano, drums, and brass instruments. The result is a sound that feels alive. Opening act. Prohibition was enforced throughout the 1920s. People would go to speakeasies where they could dance to popular music and unwind. Ira Gershwin and Fats Waller were two artists who helped kick off the jazz age. The Great Depression took a toll on the United States in the 1930s. People needed to forget their troubles. Musicians like Benny Goodman and Glenn Miller played lively and upbeat songs. They wanted to offset the negative times. Headliner. In the 1940s, Charlie Parker, Thelonious Monk, and others created a new movement. It was called bebop. It used even more improvisation. Each musician took a solo, never making the same song twice. The 1950s brought jazz musicians like Dave Brubeck and Miles Davis. They were known for modal jazz. It shifted the song's importance from harmony to melody. During the 60s and 70s, rock music was very popular. John Coltrane and Herbie Hancock had to break down usual jazz with free jazz. It was more creative. It drew from music all around the world. Jazz lost steam in the 80s and 90s until Diana Krall created a mix of modern music with old-time jazz. Her 1999 album, When I Look in Your Eyes, was nominated by the Grammys for Album of the Year. Wynton Marsalis has won an incredible...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.